Hello, Libras. I'm lachondevi with Power Life Hypnosis, and this is your mid-June 2019 love and romance reading. As always, a big thank you to all of those who thumbs up and like my readings. Thank you to all of those who comment and share, and thank you to all of my old subscribers as well as all of my new subscribers. To book a reading with me, you can do so at my website, powerlifehypnosis.com. You can also book a reading with me today through the description box below. If you would like to know or confirm or would like more information and details about your future long-term partner, when you'll meet your partner, where you meet your partner, what your partner will look like, how to recognize your partner, additional details that I do not share here, as well as a full reading as to how to align yourself with your future partner and your most fulfilling ideal relationship, book a future partner reading with me through the description box or again at my website, powerlifehypnosis.com. If you have an iPhone or an iPad, you can contact me at any time through the free Instant Go app. The link for that is instantgo.com/powerlifehypnosis. I am running a special through Instant Go for this month, the month of June. So send me a message. I will respond within 24 hours and throughout the end of the month. All questions will be answered for 11/11. Again, instantgo.com/powerlifehypnosis. You can find that link in the description box below as well. Also, go ahead and check me out and follow me on Instagram. I have a new Instagram where I'm posting your weekly and weekend fortunes for both love and life, as well as additional guidance messages. So again, that link is also in the description box. Follow me at powerlifehypnosis on Instagram. My lovely Libras, this is a general reading. The messages may or may not resonate. If they do not, check your moon and rising sign videos, as those messages may. You can also check your sun, moon, and rising sign videos for a more complete picture of your love life during the ending portion of this month, June 2019. And you can also cross-watch the reading for your romantic interest as well, as that reading may provide you with additional messages. And also, go ahead and check out the extended June reading that was posted earlier this month. If this is your first time to my channel, or if you have not seen that reading yet, that reading does go into very specific details regarding who you may be involved with, what this person may look like, their sign, their energy, as well as how you can increase your money, your abundance, and your prosperity during the month of June. And I do have two descriptions in that reading. So I do like the June readings. Again, go ahead and check them out if this is your first time to my channel, or if you have not seen that reading before this one, go ahead and view it when you are finished watching this reading. So my dears, let's go ahead and go into our reading here. Okay, so first off, we're gonna start with the energy, then we're gonna go into our prediction and our guidance. Regarding the overall energy of what you may face, or the overall energy of your love life during the ending portion of this month, June, I have here. Okay. First off, I'm gonna go here because this card flew out of the deck, popped out of the deck very strongly, you know, very forcefully, and wanted to make itself known. So let's start here. Pay attention to the red flags, the signs are cautioning you. Libras, it appears as though during this time, many of you may be noting, recognizing, seeing some red flags. Okay, and one thing that I just heard in my inner ear is some of you may be dismissing or ignoring red flags as well. And the interesting thing is that is not uncommon. You know, it is very common for us to kind of dismiss or gloss over or glaze over or not fully acknowledge and recognize red flags. Nevertheless, red flags are not just, you know, shiny adornments. Red flags are there in order to help us open our eyes, in order to help us look at a situation for what it is, or in order to warn us about a particular situation, or warn us that if we keep moving forward in this direction, or if things continue forward in this way, there may be some challenges and some complications arising as a result. So, for many of you, there may be some signs cautioning you during the end of this month. All right, so pay attention to the red flags. Don't gloss over them, don't dismiss them, don't shift your eyes and not look at them. They are there for a reason. Spirit guide, universe, your higher power, your guide, your guardian angels, your spiritual support team provides you with these red flags to show you what direction to move in. Or again, if we continue doing the same thing and moving down this path, there may be challenges. So red flags, again, are not shiny adornments. They're not just decorations. They're something to take note of and to act accordingly. All right. So there may be some red flags that some of you may have already recognized and experienced. Some of you may be seeing some red flags surfacing during the ending portion of this month. All right, but there are some red flags here. There are some signs. And for some of you, the signs may even be regarding our own actions and our way of going about relationships and moving forward, okay? And for others, because this is a general reading, it's going to resonate in different ways, the signs may be regarding our partners, our romantic interests, whoever we are coming to this reading, thinking about, whoever's on our mind, whoever's in our heart. This person may be indicating some red flags. There may be some stop signs or some warning signs, some caution signs that this person is displaying. So it could be that person or it could be ourselves. We may have patterns, behaviors, beliefs, ways of thinking that may cause challenges in our romantic relationships, okay? So that's going to resonate with you all in different ways. So just pay attention to the red flags. And again, this is either going to be this person's actions. For many of you, it may be this person's actions. For others of you, these red flags and these warning signs may be regarding how we are showing up in this connection, okay? Now, we are also being guided to, or we also have the energy of letting go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. So yes, there are red flags. Yes, there are things to be cautious of and aware of and mindful of and just to pay attention to, okay? At the same time, it is necessary, or we may be practicing letting go of control issues and once again allowing the situation to unfold. So some of us may be observing, okay, taking a step back because we're letting go of the need to control or force the trajectory of this situation or the events that unfold. So we are taking a step back and we are reflecting, or I'm sorry, not reflecting, but observing, okay? We are observing the situation. We are observing their actions. We are observing their energy, their words. We are observing how we feel, how we perceive this situation. We are allowing the situation to unfold without trying to force it in a particular direction. Okay? Because really, we are not in control of others and what they do and how they show up in life and how they love and how they relate to us. We are not in control of that. All we can do is meet them, you know, where they are or not, or do our best in our connections. But we do not have control over another. We do not have control over another's actions, okay? So some of us may be recognizing this and maybe looking at their actions, looking at, you know, some red flags and seeing that. All right. And realizing that the best thing that we can do is take a step back and observe. All right. In order to make an informed decision regarding how to move forward in love or move forward in this situation, or how to handle what it is that we are facing in the end of June. Also, Libras, it is safe for you to love. Okay. So, I'm sorry, excuse me, my dog is just snoring his little butt off. I'm gonna take a card here, or maybe a little piece of paper, kind of toss it at him. Hey, boo. Shh, shh, shh. Thank you. Okay, excuse me, my dog is just in dreamland right now, and it can be a little distracting, you know. Okay, so. Also, again, it is safe for you to love. Open your heart to give and receive the highest energy of all. So again, let go of the need to control. Just have an open heart, but at the same time, we may be looking at the truth of the situation or the underlying energies, or we are just paying attention. All right, we are just noting the red flags. Okay, or we are noting the signs, noticing the signs and becoming aware of them. So let's go ahead and go into here our prediction. So I have here the bouquet. I also have here the clouds. The bouquet, the clouds, as well as the lady. I have here the snake as well as the heart. My little baby went right back to sleep. That did not do anything. Well, I hope that you guys aren't able to hear his snore. I apologize if you can't. Excuse me, I'm gonna drink some coffee here. All right. So, with this combination, the first thing that I can see here is there may be some kind of talk, hearing something through the grapevine, some kind of gossip. You know, you may hear something that is affecting this situation. Now, that being said, for those of you who hear something that may cause some doubts or some worries or some confusion here, what I have to say about that is, yes, take the information in. If you receive some information from an outside source, or you know, some information comes to you, finds its way to you, yes, you know, pay attention, all right, because I don't know this information coming up. So depending on what it is, yes, pay attention, you know, take it into consideration. However, it's interesting. I'm also hearing that song, Heard It Through the Grapevine, playing in my inner ear. And there's that line of, believe half of what you see and none of what you hear. So really it's up to you. If you get some outside information, or there's some gossip, or there's some, you know, talk about this situation or your partner or what they're doing or whatever it is, you know, yes, believe half of what you see and none of what you hear at the same time. Okay, so these can be simultaneous truths here, simultaneous actions. All right, take everything that you hear from an outside source with a grain of salt. At the same time, pay attention to the red flags. All right, because, you know, in reality, if we had a partner who was doing their thing, acting, you know, with respect to themselves and us and our relationship, and things were, you know, in the best place, we likely wouldn't be hearing things from outside sources. But go with what your gut is telling you, how you feel about this situation. And again, don't ignore any red flags. You know, for example, if you hear something about some kind of cheating or infidelity or betrayal, or, you know, somebody's doing some sneaky stuff or anything like that, you know, take that into consideration. And at the same time, take into consideration how you feel about it. How you feel about it. Do you think that that's true? You know, does that reflect upon, you know, yourself, your partner, your connection? You know, make an informed decision regarding the information you hear, and that informed decision can be dismissing it. That informed decision can be, you know, looking at the situation more closely. Okay, do what it is that you feel is best. So with this combination here, I can see that you are involved with somebody who may be very attractive, somebody who you may have very strong romantic feelings for, okay? Somebody may be very charming. Libras. Okay, and I started getting chills, so that tells me that that message is right. I'm feeling as though many of you are with somebody who's very charming, okay? This person's very charming. They know what to say. They know what to do. They know how to get you because they've likely done it before. This is somebody who may have a cold mouthpiece. You know, they know how to talk to you. They know how to bring you in. They're very charming. I'm seeing somebody here who's very, very charming, okay? Now, I'm also seeing that some of you may experience something that may come to a as a surprise to you. All right? There may be a surprise that occurs, something unexpected that transpires. And this situation, what goes on here, may likely cause some confusion, some sadness, some trouble thinking, maybe some uncertainty regarding how to move forward in this situation or what to do here. All right? Some challenges in thinking. Again, some doubts, some worries. I'm seeing here kind of a warning going on. Okay? So, regarding this lady card, you could be this lady, or this could be who you are romantically involved with. Take this as it resonates, okay? If you're in a same-sex relationship, this is likely, if for the females, you, for the males, a more feminine energy here. And some of you maybe hearing something, or there may be something that occurs regarding a rival, another woman in particular, or, you know, this can be, even if you're male, you know, another man or something like that. Some of you may be experiencing some kind of challenges here regarding someone else affecting this situation. So it can be the gossip, and that's where that comes in, or these, you know, messages, and that's where that comes in, or there may be something going on regarding another woman or someone else in this relationship that may challenge it during this time. Some of you may just have kind of a bad feeling, like a feeling of dread, or you know, you're expecting something bad to happen or something like that, a bad feeling going on with this situation, with this connection. Others of you, I do see here some betrayal. I see here an instance, an occasion of betrayal. Some of you may be feeling betrayed by your partner, or you may even betray your partner, because this is a general reading, so the energies can be vice versa, okay? Take this as it resonates. But I do see here a situation where somebody may be left feeling betrayed. There may be some complications, some challenges. So this is kind of a warning to watch out during this time. So yes, pay attention to these red flags, because you will likely be receiving them. Okay, you will likely be receiving a red flag. Don't ignore it. Don't gloss over it and only see what you wish to see, because that's what leads us to trouble. When we have red flags come up, but we choose not to look at them and ignore them and only see what we want to see, because we want something to work out, or we want something to occur a certain way, you know, that can lead us to challenges. So it may be very useful to pay attention, all right? There's a warning, look out. Yes, this may bring some confusion and some uncertainty, okay? And this may not be something that you were expecting, or this may come as a surprise to you. Some of you may be dealing with someone who's a narcissist, and you may not be fully aware of that. Sorry to say it, but I do see it here. So some of you may be dealing with somebody who may not have your best interest in mind, you know, even if they portray themselves as otherwise, or even if they portray themselves as having your best interest in mind. Some of you may be dealing with somebody who's a little narcissistic here. And again, I do see somebody here, and I do see a situation here at the end of this month where there may be some trouble ahead, some complications, some challenges. This is a warning here in this romantic relationship. Be careful with your heart, all right? Know that it is safe for you to love. So keep an open heart, but remain vigilant, you know, remain observant here. Okay. Be careful. Just be careful. Okay. So again, in the center here, we do have this card of the snake, which speaks of lies, cheating, infidelity, betrayal, challenges, complications. Watch out. This is a warning. All right. So I just want to give you guys that information. And I'm sorry. I always have to apologize when, you know, challenging cards come up. You know, however, I'm just the interpreter of the messages. I just provide the messages. But it's always better for us to know what is going to occur so we can make an informed decision when we do face this situation. You know, that's always better than not knowing. You're just being in the dark and not knowing what to do. So regarding what to do in this situation, okay, how to bring about the best outcome here. Let's get into that. Okay. First off, ground yourself. Is that why I just took that breath, that grounding breath? Ground yourself, Libras. Now's the time to ground yourself. When you find yourself in this situation, all right, center yourself, ground yourself. When you face doubts, worries, complications, uncertainties, you know, you're unsure about this situation. When you see the red flags, the best thing for you to do is first ground yourself and center yourself. And when you do so, you'll be able to, instead of, you know, having all this mental confusion and chatter and things going around, hear the messages, hear the direction that your guides, that your spiritual support team are giving to you. So the first thing that you can do if you face a challenge here, the first thing that I'm advising when you face a challenge, if you face a challenge, okay? Because we really don't want that. However, if you find yourself in that position, ground yourself. When you detach from awareness of your body and the physical world, Libras, you become ungrounded. And you're also Libras, you're the scales, you're about balance, all right? So balance out that energy. You know, align yourself with your Libra energy of balance. Although it is pleasant to float heavenward, your attention and your work are needed upon the earth. We're helping you to balance, once again, balance the spiritual and material so that you can enjoy a fulfilling earthly life. Okay, so if you find yourself, if you should find yourself in a situation where there's something unexpected, a surprise, something that you didn't think was coming, or you see something that you didn't think, you know, was there, whatever happens, first thing is pause. Breathe. Ground yourself. Center yourself. You know, balance those Libra scales, okay? Now, I also have the card of have confidence. So, moving forward does not necessarily require you to have confidence in yourself, all right? Moving forward does not necessarily require you to have confidence in yourself, because we are all subconsciously, as human beings, we all have a fear of the unknown. You know, that is our biggest fear as humans, with a human brain, with a human mind, all right? That's universal. So moving forward doesn't require us to have confidence in ourselves, because confidence in God is enough, along with knowing that God works through you and with you in all ways. Lean upon us, God, Spirit, Universe, your higher power, your spiritual support team, your guardian angels, your guides. Lean upon us if your confidence wavers, okay? Lean upon us if your confidence wavers, and we will buoy your courage, and we will buoy your faith. Now, Libras, a strong message that I have coming up for you guys is get in touch with, ask for, set the intention, put out into the universe what it is that you want. Ask for what you want. Become clear about what it is that you want and desire. What do you desire? What do you want? If you can have anything in the world, if you can have any situations, circumstances, outcome in your romantic relationships, in your love life, what would that be and what would that look like? Take some time to explore that and to become clear. about your ultimate outcome and what it is that you are seeking to manifest and bring forth into your life. Let the universe and other people know what you need. So for some of you, it may be useful to ask for what it is that you want from a partner, from a person, or if not, the universe. Okay? And what do you desire, Libras? You now have the opportunity to write the script according to your heart's true desire. So now is the time to be clear about what it is that you want, what it is that you seek, what it is that you desire. All right. If you can manifest anything in your life, what would that be? Become clear about that vision, that outcome. And as you do so, you shall align with that. Okay, so you now have the opportunity to write the script according to your heart's true desires. Once you clearly decide upon your true desires, Libra, and know that you're ready and deserving of them, they will rush into your life as if by magic. Become clear about what it is that you want. If you can have anything in the world, what would it be that you ask for? And go ahead and ask for what you want. Ask the universe, ask your partner, ask other people for what it is that you want, need, and desire, okay? Now, last but not least, we have our postcard from Spirit, which reads, Dearest Libra, we have a secret for you. We have a secret. The more you think you know, the more you think you know, the less you actually do. So if you're willing to keep an open mind, if you're willing to keep an open mind, keep an open heart, okay? You will avoid the narrow confines of the know-it-all and open up to the unlimited potential that can be discovered only by the curious optimist. Curiosity allows you to discover new things, see the world from a different perspective, and find answers to the questions you might not even know you have. Right now, whatever is going on, it is important to know that you are not aware. So you are not yet aware from this current vantage point, from where you are right here, right now, in this time and place, whenever you're watching this, it's important for you to know that you're not aware of all the aspects of it that you need to make an informed choice. So again, allow the situation to unfold like golf control issues, because there are things in the background, there are things in the unseen realm, there are things to this situation that you aren't aware of at this moment, and you aren't meant to be aware of those things at this moment. So allow things to unfold and know that everything will become illuminated and be brought to the light in divine timing. You might be projecting a story that isn't totally true, Libras. So moving forward, your mantra can be, I don't know. I don't know yet, all right? Or, that's interesting. As you keep your mind and as you keep your heart open to new experiences, so again, open your heart and open your mind to give and receive the highest energy of all right? Keep your mind and your heart open to new experiences and a richer existence overall. All of us over here want you to be all that you can be. We're cheering for you. Can you hear us? Libras, these are the messages that I have for you for your love and romantic relationships during the ending portion of June. Thumbs up, like this reading if the messages resonate with you. Comment, share, subscribe to my channel if you have not already. Also, to book a private reading with me, you can do so today through the description box. You can also book a reading at my website, powerlifehypnosis.com. Follow me on Instagram, powerlifehypnosis, for your weekly love life fortunes and additional guidance messages. Also, take advantage of that instant go special that we have going throughout the month of June. Much love, much light to you, of course, today and always. Wishing you all the best of luck in your love life and in all your endeavors. And thank you for spending this time with me, and I look very forward to seeing you here again soon. Bye, Libras. The best of luck and take care. Mwah. Love you all.